In this example, we're going to practice verifying a solution to a differential equation. The directions state, verify that y equals 2e to the negative 3t is a solution to y prime of t plus 3y of t equals 0. So this right here is what's called a differential equation. It's a equation that involves a derivative, right? We see this y prime of t in there. Sometimes you'll see a second or third derivative. And generally, the goal of the differential equation is to actually find that original function y of t. But here, we're actually given a proposed solution, a proposed function y, and we want to verify or see if it indeed is a solution to the differential equation. So this is actually a pretty simple process. I'm just going to take this function y and plug it into this differential equation and see if it gives me a true statement. Now, to do that in this case, I'm going to need to know what y prime of t is. So let's go ahead and calculate that. So I'm given y of t. And I want to know y prime of t, which is just a derivative. So I need to take the derivative of 2e to the negative 3t. Well, the 2 is a constant, so it can stay out front. The derivative of e to the negative 3t is e to the negative 3t times negative 3. So it looks like we end up with negative 6e to the negative 3t overall. Okay, so now we have y prime of t. The other part of this differential equation is this y of t, but that's just our original function. So it looks like we're ready to plug in. Okay, so y prime of t plus 3y of t. I want to see if that equals 0. Well, y prime of t, we just said that was negative 6. E to the negative 3t plus 3 times y of t, 2e to the negative 3t. So we get negative 6e to the negative 3t plus 6e to the negative 3t. So that actually does equal 0. So then we conclude that y equals e to the negative 3t is a solution to y prime of t plus 3y of t equals 0. And that's all you have to do to verify a solution to a differential equation. In this example, we're going to verify a solution to a differential equation. But instead of a specific solution, we're going to verify what's called a general solution. So a differential equation is going to have a family of functions that satisfies it. So this comes from whenever you integrate a function, you end up with a family of functions as the answer, right? You remember the plus c. So this is the same idea. There's going to be a whole family of solutions that satisfies a given differential equation. So here, we're given a general solution, y equals c e to the negative 3t. Here, c just represents any constant. And we want to verify that it's a solution of this differential equation, y prime of t plus 3y of t equals 0. So we're going to approach this in the exact same way as we would if we were trying to verify a single solution. So I basically want to take my proposed solution, y, and plug it into my differential equation and see if it satisfies the relationship. Okay, so I've got this y equals c e to the negative 3t. If I look at my differential equation, I see that I need to know y prime of t. That's the derivative. Okay, so if I take the derivative of y, the c, which is a constant, is just going to stay out front. Then I've got e to the negative 3t times negative 3. So negative 3 times c, e to the negative 3t, is my first derivative. So the other part of my differential equation here is just y of t, but that's just the original function. So let's go ahead and plug in and see if we can get this relationship to work out. Okay, so y prime of t, I just said that was negative 3c, e to the negative 3t, plus 3 times y of t. So 3 times ce to the negative 3t. So I can see right away that that does actually equal 0. So then my conclusion is that this function, y equals ce to the negative 3t, is a solution of y prime of t plus 3y of t equals 0. So this, I verified a general solution in this case. And what this tells me is that any specific solution that follows this form, so for example, a second ago, we looked at, I think it was y equals 2e to the negative 3t. And we verified that was the solution. So any constant c that I plug in there, that's also going to be a solution. So y equals 5e to the negative 3t, y equals 100e to the negative 3t, negative 100e to the negative 3t. Any solution that follows this form is going to be a solution of this differential equation. So this is how we verify solutions, and specifically general solutions, of differential equations.